use of Simeox in different patients with bronchiectasis?
Mrs. Chairman, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, first of all, for invitation. It's my privilege to speak here about the initial experience with Simeox in the Czech Republic. We performed a controlled prospective randomized study. It's just a pilot study demonstrating non-inferiority of Simeox device versus traditional manual physiotherapy technique for managing the airway clearance in patients with bronchiectasis. The Simeox was applied 20 minutes twice a day per 5 days, and these 5 days also manual physiotherapy took place. And the primary endpoint was feasibility. Then we asked about safety, we measured spirometry, we measured chest expansion on the xiphoid processus level, the thorax. We measured saturation of oxygen when we used pulse oximetry, and we also collected the mucus every day. We recruited 12 patients during this period, March till the end of April. Formerly, we wanted to test especially patients with COPD, but in this short period, we had a huge epidemic of influenza, so we had to concentrate to more isolated patients, which were patients with cystic fibrosis. But anyway, we had some patients with COPD and IPF as well. We used statistics, despite it was a very small study, we used a non-parametric test like Mann-Whitney when we compared independent values of these two groups, and Peer-Wilkinson test for timely dependent values inside each group. Limit of significance was p less than 0.05. So 12 patients, 7 men, 5 women, mean age 46 years, 7 cystic fibrosis, 3 COPD, 2 IPF with traction bronchiectasis. Here you can see the pulmonary function changes inside group of Simeox and group of manual physiotherapy. There was increase of FEV1 in absolute numbers and also in percentage. We suppose that it will be decrease of residual volume, but we didn't observe it. And there was increase of chest this extension. It was significant. Only this result was significant in both groups. Here we added the collection of sputum, and we compared the results of two groups, and there was no statistical difference. There was difference in oxygen saturation during the period of the procedure, and it was in the both groups that before and after the procedure we can observe the improvement of O2 saturation. When we compare the results between the two groups, it was not statistically significant. Probably this is the most important result. The only statistically significant change between the group of Simeox and group of physiotherapy, classic physiotherapy, the significant increase of SO2 in Simeox group during the five-day procedure. So it was a longitudinal trend of improvement of saturation in the group of patients with Simeox procedure. The difference was small, but as it was the steadily increase, it was significant from 92, the median 92% of oxygen saturation to 95.5% of oxygen saturation. I can show three patients with different diagnoses. One was a 71-year-old male with COPD and bronchiectasis. FEV1 improved from 62% to 67%. Residual volume increased a little bit, but it didn't change a lot. Chest expansion was from 5 to 6 centimeter during expiration and inspiration of the thorax, and CO2 increased from 95 to 98% in the end of the procedure. Sputum production was quite high. The second patient is a 23-year-old male with cystic fibrosis. He had a really bad pulmonary functions. FEV1 improved from 28% to 49%. Residual volume decreased substantially. There was a small change in chest expansion and surprisingly also in SO2, but it was quite good. And sputum production was from 20 to 10 milliliter per day. In interstitial pulmonary fibrosis, we are not sure about the effectiveness of the procedure. This patient had no change in spirometry, in chest expansion, also in sputum production. The only change was, surprisingly, in SO2. So we can conclude that three types of patients had different results after the Simeox procedure, but in all of the patients some improvement was observed. So we can conclude that Simeox was tolerated by all patients. Really, it is easy to use, easy to handle, and all patients appreciated the device and found it comfortable. We didn't find any safety signal, any pneumothorax or some other complication. No inferiority in effectiveness of Simeox compared to classic manual physiotherapy was observed. There were no statistical significant differences between both therapeutic procedures. And during these procedures, we observed improvement of oxygen saturation as well as chest expansion. Statistically significant trend of CO2 longitudinal improvement was detected during 5 days of Simeox procedures. Thank you.